Then okay with going with you?
Yeah, he said he's fine. I said, well, have you got some lunch? Because we're not going to be back till like 4:30-ish. Maybe a little later, I don't know. He said, yeah, actually, today I did bring something. I said, all right.
This isn't going.
You have to hold it for a second. That's what I don't like about that thing, too. You can't just tap. You got to hold it, and then it takes off on you. So, oh, yeah. So on these now, I need to show you more than this, but since you're here, LJ said we need to change these perimeters, the width to 300 and the height to 225.
We can't save them in there.
No, you got to go a little long way around the mountain now.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so that should be working. What is this? I have no idea. I've never seen that before.
I'll go look.
All my burdens are I have prayed my final prayer. Don't you cry over my body, 'cause that ain't me lying there. No, I am standing on the mountain. I can hear the angel's song. I am reaching over Jordan. Take my hand, Lord, lead me home. I am standing on the mountain. I can hear the angels call. I am reaching over Jordan, take my hand, Lord, lead me home. Take my hand, Lord, lead me home.
It's like you haven't been gone a moment from my side. Like the tears will never cry, like the hands of time holding you and me. And with all my heart, I'm sure we're closer than we ever were. I don't have to hear or see. I've got all proof on me.
There are more than angels watching over me.
I believe Oh, I believe. Now when you die, your life goes on. It doesn't end here when you're gone. Every soul is filled with light. It never ends with a light. Our love can't even reach across eternity. I believe. Oh, I believe. Forever you're a part of me. Forever in the heart of me. I will hold you even longer if I can. Oh, the people who don't see the most see that I believe in ghosts. If that makes me crazy, then I am. Skin, I feel you come back again. And I
a hooker and a preacher,
breaking up and tearing up everything that nobody can. Children and parents can't get it on. Husband and wife just can't get along. Lord, you're the healer of a broken home in a broken land. Heard it on the news just the other day. Another little child's been kidnapped, they say. Lord, I can't help but think of the pain that this family is in. Said they found his little body down the road, beaten and bruised and battered so. Lord, I can't help but wonder when all the pain will end. Take away the pain, Lord, send us some laughter. Take away the heartache, bring on the sunshine we're seeking after. So much hurting all around. Lord, you're the only one that can be found. Even so, come, Lord Jesus, take away the pain. Even so, come, Lord Jesus, take away the pain.
You've been in the storm. Has been all so long. Your ship has lost anchor, and the storm's got you drifting. But the night's almost over, so right at your storm. Your storm, God's right there with you. You may not feel me, oh, but you're not alone. You're hurting now, but your morning is coming. Just hold on to Jesus and ride at your storm. Just hold on to Jesus and ride out your storm. Ride out your storm.
know, family, that's a true song right there. If you'll just hold on to Jesus, you know, he'll help you right out the storm, Jerry Lynn. I know that, you know, we go through storms of this life, and this is one of them. It's a time, but, you know, just like that song says, you may not feel the Lord, but you just hold on to him. He's there. He'll be there for you. So we're going to do the obituary, and then we're going to do a few more songs. Said Herschel Thomas, Tom Adams of Winchester, Ohio, born on December the 15th, 1944 in Cincinnati, Ohio, went home to be with the Lord on January 30th, 2021 at the age of 76. Beloved husband of 13 years to Jerry Lynn Lane Adams, loving father of Eric, Tina Adams, Terry Adams, Mike Adams, Jerry, Amanda Horn, and Jesse, Tanya Horn, proud pap of Lexi, Sammy, Wyatt, Hunter, Michaela, Gage, Gracie, Caden, Jackson, Lucas, Logan, Aiden, Nevaeh, Molly, and Paisley, dear brother of Faye Kurt Hammonds, also survived by numerous nieces, nephews, relatives, and many dear friends preceded in death by his first wife, Pearl Bullock Adams, brother Jimmy Adams, and his parents, Herman Thomas and Molly Cole Adams. Tom proudly served in the United States Army during the Vietnam War. He was a member of the Masonic Winchester Lodge 236 and Scottish Rite Valley of Cincinnati. Tom enjoyed fishing, hunting, racing, farming, eating, and the outdoors. He loved to tell stories. He adored his family, especially his grandchildren.
There's a day just out in front of us, I know will surely come, when that eastern sky will open wide, revealing God's dear Son. And I know from here to heaven is the twinkling of an eye, and in the midst of all his glory, we'll hear the sweetest cry. Welcome home, I knew you'd come. Welcome home, you're here for good. And look around, and everywhere you look, our friends, all the greetings will be precious by the ones we love so dear. No mortal man has ever seen or heard what we'll hear. Welcome home, I knew you'd come. Look around, was it worth the wait? Welcome home, step through the gate. Welcome home, I knew you'd come. Welcome home, you're here. Look around, was it worth the wait? Welcome home, step through the gate. Welcome home.
Well, that's beautiful. Don't get much better than that. Tommy was a really good friend. Taught us a lot as little boys, worked on a whole lot of cars, busted a lot of knuckles. And he could tell some tales. But he's a good man. Good friend. Thank you.
changed the rest of my life. I found the way in my body, found my strength when I was born, found a place to meet my burden. Wish I could trade the dark sky, beaming rays of sunshine, found the living in my belly, and it blew all the time. Down and broken hearted for the problem they're clouding in your mind. And you're searching for the answer, but your trouble's getting worse all the time. Just take your heart to Jesus, it'll take you in and break. He's living in your body. You can watch him do all the time. I found a lily in the valley. And I found shelter from the storm. A place where I could trade those dark skies, beneath rays of sunshine. Found the living in the valley. And it blooms all the time. Jesus is a lily in the valley. And it blooms all the time.
Family, a lot to say today. We love you. And you know, it's such a time, you know, we try to prepare for this, but, you know, we think we do, but we never get prepared for this. But, you know, it's done already been said, just like the gentleman said, Tom was a fine man. I tell you, I enjoyed Tom. And if I could, before I get started, I'm just going to share just a little story with about Tom, and then we'll bring a message, because I believe Tom would want me to. You know, it the good news we hear from Jerry Lynn that Tom gave his heart to the Lord. You know, that's the best thing we can do in this walk of life, because, you know, but I'm thankful to hear that. And but, you know, as Tom would get to come to Kentucky as what we call Cousins Day, you know, so. But I tell you, he dearly loved that Jerry Lynn, you know, to get to come. And I saw some films out there sitting around, and he would just mingle right around, and he would talk. I tell you, he dearly loved that. And I tell you, Tom was one of those persons that you wanted to be sure that you got to talk to that day. Boy, he'd have stories to tell. I mean, good stories. And he'd tell them stories, and he was just a kind. Seemed to me like Jerry Lynn, you know, just a kind, gentle man. But, you know, he'd make you feel good about yourself if you talk to him that day. You know, he'd just make you feel good. But he would just love to tell them stories. And I can just see him now when we're sitting down there on Law Lake. Him just going from, he'd go from this one to that one. wherever the music was at, and then somebody to talk to, Tom was. And I tell you, you know what? He'll surely be missed. Life's short on this side of life, friend, but you know, eternal life, Jesus Christ offers eternal life. And I believe that Tom's got that now because he gave his heart to the Lord. And, you know, I'm thankful to hear that. And but life's short on this side of life. So that's what I'm going to preach about today. I'm going to be in Job chapter 14 and verse 1. It says, man that is born of woman is a few days and full of trouble. You know, Tom, I said on the obituary, Tom lived to be 76 years old. But friend, when it comes time to give up a loved one, seemed like we just had him for just a short time. I mean, you know, 76 years is a good long life on this walk of life. But when it comes time to give them up, you know, it seemed that just a few days. And you know, and it says it's full of trouble. We're full of trouble. You know, sickness comes, heartaches comes, friend, and the old trouble comes. But I tell you, you know, and we don't never know what's going to come our way, but we know. Then he would go right on down to in verse 5 in that same chapter, verse 4, chapter 14, at verse 5, it says, seeing his days are determined, the number of his months are with thee, thou hast appointed his bounds that they cannot pass. You see, man, we cannot pass the bounds of death. And, you know, it's appointed, Hebrews chapter 9 and verse 27, it's appointed unto men once to die. But after this, the judgment, you know. So I believe today, Tom, he would want me to tell you this. Life is uncertain. Friend, life is surely uncertain. We don't know what tomorrow may bring forth. We don't know what 1 minute will bring forth. But life is uncertain. But death is for sure, friend, you know. And I believe if Tom, I believe if he would want me to say anything, Jerry Lynn, you know what I believe he'd want me to tell you. Us to be ready, be prepared for when this time comes, friend, because it's going to come to each and every one of us. That's what the scripture said. Appointed unto men wants to die. That means that we're not going to escape it. I'm not going to escape it. You're not going to escape it. If the Lord tarries, is coming long enough, we'll not escape that. That is the appointment we're going to keep, friend. So I tell you, and you know, I thought about to be ready. I believe Tom would want me to tell you to be ready. And the best way I can tell you that is John 3:16. It said, God gave his only begotten son that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but will have everlasting life. I believe Tom's got that everlasting life, friend. It said, whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. I tell you, then John 3:17 goes on to say that Jesus sent not his son in the world to condemn the world, but the world through him might be saved. You see, God made a way through his son. I tell you, I believe Tom would want me to tell you that today. But you know, the scripture talks about a beautiful place. 1 Corinthians, I believe it's 1 Corinthians 2:9. It says, I have not seen nor ear heard. Either has it entered into the heart of man what God has prepared for him, for those that love him. You know, Tom, he loved the Lord. He gave his heart to him, friend. And you know, I believe that the scripture talks about walls of jasper, gates of pearl, and streets of gold, friend. You know what, Jerry Lynn, I believe Tom's experiencing them today because he gave his heart to the Lord. Not nothing we do, friend, but what the Lord Jesus Christ done for us on that old rugged cross, friend. He gave his life for us that we could have life. And I believe today that Tom's experiencing that. You know, I believe, I don't know about you, but I believe every word of the Bible. If I didn't believe all of it, I wouldn't believe none of it, friend. So I believe every word of it, and it says. So you think about that. So today, if you're here today and you've not never made preparations to meet the Lord Jesus Christ, I pray that you do that today because, you know, like I said, it's time short on this earth. You know, 76 years, Jerry Lynn's a long time on this earth. A lot of people never makes it, but Tom lived a good life. And like I say, he's a special man. We're surely going to miss him today. So, but if, I tell you one thing to hold on to. If you're here today and you're a Christian, you got the promise that you'll be able to see him again one day. If you're not, friend, I tell you, I believe if you ever see Tom again, you'll have to make preparations to do that. So I know the family's wore out and tired, but we want to say again, family, we love you. if there's anything we can ever do, we'll be glad to do. You just call. I know we live in Kentucky, but you know what? Same God in Kentucky is the same God in Ohio. So, he can do anything. So if you ever want to call on us, you feel free to do that. But, I thought about this. what's been for Kentucky and everybody. But Tom was just a simple man. And you know what? He loved his family. He loved his country. Well, and I tell you, I'm proud to get to know Tom. I'm honored to get to do this today. Sometimes I get this a little bit nervous, but I tell you, for Tom, Jerry Lynn, it was a blessing to get to do this. And I thank the family for thinking enough of me to let me do this. But I pray today. I believe this with all my heart. I want you to listen to this, and then we'll not hold too much long. We've got a long way to go with the funeral home. But I believe with all my heart, as good as Tom liked his family and good as he liked life, after what he's experienced today, I believe you could ask him to come back, Jerry Lynn. Even though he dearly loved his family, you know what I believe he would say? No, you know what? I'm in such a beautiful place. And you know what he'd say? It don't hurt no more. You see, there's no sickness where he's at. No more sickness, no more pain, friend. And I tell you what, I believe he'd say, just wish you was here. So you think about that. If you ever want to see Tom again, friend, you'll have to make preparations. And I tell you what, God loves you today. And one scripture says, for whosoever call upon the name of the Lord, he shall be saved. So you won't turn nobody away if you call upon him, but we want to say again, family, that we love you, and we want to thank everybody that, on behalf of the family, that's come and supported whatever you did, the food or whatever you've done. We want to thank the funeral home for such a nice hospitality. We want to thank everybody for that. But we're going to come to a close now, and we'll go to the Lord in prayer. So let's bow our head. Our dear, kind, and gracious Heavenly Father, we come to you today just thanking you, Father, for this beautiful day that you blessed us with. And Father, we thank you for the time that we got to know Brother Tom. And Father, we know that we'll get to meet him someday again. So we're thankful, Father, for him and what he was, what he meant to us, Lord. And we thank you for this family. And Lord, we pray that they'll just look to you. We know, Lord, that there'll be an empty spot. And Lord, we know there's sorrow and trouble in their heart, but we know that if they'll look to you, Father, you can take care of that. Father, we pray you just reach down your big hand of mercy and kindness upon them, Father, that you just help them through this time, Father, because we know that it's a trying time right now. But, Father, we love you. And, Father, we'll never fail to step aside and give you the praise and the honor and the glory. For we ask it all in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
This concludes this portion of our services here at the funeral home for Tom. If all of you can kindly remain seated, we have a staff member dismiss you by rows. You'll come down the aisle to most of your right side, this aisle here. I'll have the family up here, Jerry and the kids, and then you'll pass by them, pay your final respects to Tom, pass by Faye and family, and then you exit out through these doors here. We are going to Linwood Cemetery in Russellville. Linwood Cemetery in Russellville. It's a pretty good distance away. I ask that everyone turn your headlights and flashers on. Everyone should have a purple flag on their vehicle. And please stay in the procession. We do go through red lights once we get caution there. Please stay with us. We need to stay in the procession the entire time, okay? On behalf of Jerry and family, I'd like to thank all those who came out last night. What a wonderful turnout we had last night. And all of you today, again, thank you for sharing this time with family. I'd like to thank the Sounds of Glory, who truly make music glorified. Thank you very much. Dwayne and Connie. And Roger and Charlotte. Thank you very much for beautiful singing. And then Kenny made a comment that said you couldn't get any better, but then he came up here. Kenny and Sonia, thank you very much for your beautiful singing this morning. Appreciate that. The following gentlemen have been honored to be pallbearers today. If they can remain inside the funeral home just outside these doors here after you've passed by the casket. Eric Adams, Terry Adams, Mike Adams, Jerry Horn, Jesse Horn, and Robert Eaton. I think also everyone's invited for food and fellowship after the cemetery. Everyone's invited for food and fellowship there at the Rambler Center in Russellville. Okay, at the Rambler Center in Russell. Please rejoin the family there for food and fellowship. And I'm sure a chance to share some more interesting, good stories on Tom. So kindly remain seated. We'll be right with you for a dismissal. Thank you.
From Mexico, one was headed for vacation, one for higher education, and two of them were searching for lost souls. That driver never ever saw the stop sign, And 18-wheelers can't stop on a dime. There are free wooden crosses on the right side of the highway. Why there's not four of them, heaven only knows. I guess it's not what you take when you leave this world behind you. It's what you leave behind you when you go. That farmer left to harvest a home and 80 acres. The faith and love for growing things in his young son's heart. And that teacher left her wisdom in the minds of lots of children and did her best to give them all a better start. And that preacher whispered, can't you see the promised land? As he lay his blood-stained Bible in that hooker's hand. There are three wooden crosses on the right side of the highway. Why there's not four of them, heaven only knows. I guess it's not what you take when you leave this world behind you. It's what you leave behind you when you go. That's the story that our preacher told last Sunday, as he held that blood-stained Bible up for all of us to see. He said, bless the farmer and the teacher and the preacher. He gave this Bible to my mama, who read it to me. There are three wooden crosses on the right side of the highway. Why there's not four of them, now I guess we know. It's not what you take when you leave this world behind you. It's what you leave behind you when you go. There are three wooden crosses on the right side of highway.
It's like a storm that cuts a path. It breaks your will. It feels like that. You think you're lost, but you're not lost on your own. You're not alone. I will stand by you. I will help you through. When you've done all you can do, you can't call. I will dry your eyes. I will find your